It's not in their own hands. They must win and hope results elsewhere go in their favour to be crowned champions. The action is live. Hello and welcome, wherever you're watching. This is Goodison Park. I'm Derek Ray, joined here on the commentary box by Lee Dixon. And today could well be the day when the league title is clinched. It is Everton, and they face Brentford.
Well, you can feel the nerves in the crowd, Derek, can't you? Hopefully, the players are not sensing that. The title's there. It's up for grabs. Don't let it slip. Be brave.
Well, we know how troublesome he can be on the pitch, but what should we expect from him today, Lee?
Well, he's scoring goals for fun. It's become a habit for him, a lovely habit to have, mind. Superb form, brimming with confidence. Just one goal away from the record now. Good luck to him.
And here's how Everton line up. Would you call it 4-5-1, Lee?
Yeah, I really like this formation, Derek. 4-2-3-1, really. The two central midfield players supplying support to a three ahead of them, and then a lone striker with a number 10 just behind him.
Well, here's how the lineup looks for Brentford. This particular setup is becoming more and more in favour.
Yes, Derek, one central striker, two wingers who will provide the width, a very narrow three in midfield. A back four, the two full-backs will be expected to support, but also defend and help out the centre-backs.
Thank you, Goodison Park. Enjoy the game.
And they kick off here. James. Rice with it. Jack Grealish. Now De Ligt. Phillips. Intelligent threaded pass here. Oh, just the start they were hoping for. As it stands, they will be champions.
Well, they've been so quick out the blocks. Just look at the celebrations. The fans are going absolutely nuts. Well, here's the replay, and you can see why the manager's furious. Just really poor play, offering up possession far too easily in the danger zone. And at this level, if you're going to do that, you'll get punished. Not good enough. Well, the coach has to be happy with that. Got their noses in front. Still work to be done, though.
Opening goal of the game then. Godus. Well, I'm sure the hosts will be thinking about claiming all 3 points, but they know if results go their way, it's possible they could end the day at the summit, Lee.
Well, Derek, really getting to the serious end of the season, the pointed end, as I like to call it. Always nice to have the points in the bag. Let them chase from behind.
Well, I believe there's been a goal in the Liverpool game. Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Liverpool. 11 minutes played, 1-0.
Well, I'm not sure if you were able to hear the gasps among the crowd, but word's certainly starting to spread about the goal in the other match. As it stands, they would narrowly miss out on the title.
Well, you just wonder whether that message has got down to the players. It can be so distracting if it has. Very important you keep your focus on the job in hand, getting the result here.
Godus. Calvin Phillips. Hakimi. Oh, lovely incisive pass. Not to be this time. Well, that's how to put in a clean tackle. But a shocking pass, really. Really intense pressure applied. Will he find the net? Able to get his body in the way. It has gone over the touchline for what'll be a throw-in. James. Well, he's given it away. The cut back. Oh, maybe the equaliser. Brilliant save. Well, fortune didn't favour him. Off the post and out of play.
Well, he's really unlucky. It was worth an effort, that's for sure.
Derek, the visitors dominating possession. It's been really impressive. They have the ball. They have control. Can they use that to produce an equaliser? The pressure's building.
Time for us to bring in Alan McInally because there's been a goal at Turf Moor. Alan, tell us all about it.
It's a goal for Manchester United. 32 minutes played, 1-0.
Thank you, Alan McInally. Phillips. On the ball, Richarlison. Digne. It needs an accurate cross. Oh, he needs to clear it here. They're not giving their opponents any time to breathe. Well, a bad pass it was. Godus. Ivan Toney. It might be on for them. He made it look simple, really. Calvin Phillips. Calvert-Lewin. Moving it forward. Might be a chance here. Well, he stumped it out of there without much fuss. Well, there's the halftime whistle. They're doing everything. Plenty to consider based on what we've seen so far as the second half begins. Henry. Sergi Canos. Ivan Toney. Well, he's got past his man. The goal seemed to be at his mercy, but defenders don't always have to touch the ball to have an influence.
No, it's that pressure that comes from the defender that makes him hurry his shot. Close.
I think most fans would be pretty happy with this man's display so far.
Well, Derek, it certainly was a good 45 minutes from the lad. Obviously got the goal to give him the lead, but he's looked very, very lively as well.
And so it will be a corner. And firing it into the area. And the goalkeeper covered a lot of ground to push that away from danger. Cross fired over. Not to be this time. A sloppy pass. And they deal with the threat this time. Josh Da Silva. Counter-attacking, very much an option. Running with the ball confidently. And he takes it on. Well, the keeper has outdone himself. Wonderful save. Corner kick played in. Well, a poor attempt at a challenge and on he goes. They're trying to get right into his face. And he's in. Can he finish? And it's gone in. The team's separated by two goals now. You cannot say they don't deserve it.
Well, as we see from the replay, it's a classic pullback cross that sets up the chance. And then from there, the keeper had little chance. 2-on-1, left completely exposed, and it made for a simple finish in the end.
It's going their way, 2-0. Well, there is nothing quite like the FA Cup final, and you'll be able to see it live right here on EA TV. It's Everton facing Manchester United.
Well, there's few better days.
Well, it could be on for him here. It's got to be. And thwarting his opponent in the nick of time. And I can tell you a goal has been scored at Anfield. Alan McInally with the details.
It's a third goal for Liverpool.
Is this the moment? Well, fortune didn't favour him. Off the post and out of play.
Well, he's really unlucky. It was worth an effort, that's for sure.
And apologies to Alan McInally for having to cut him off. Just to confirm, Liverpool have scored in that match. And they are running away with it, seemingly. 3-0 in front. And it wasn't a great pass, was it? Calvert-Lewin. He's in behind. And begging to be put away. And a goal to put the final stamp on it. That will do it.
Well, here's the replay. It's a very neat piece of deception to get past the defender, and that eventually leads to what amounts to a simple task of rounding the goalkeeper. 2-1. There's only one winner.
Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change. It's a massive lead, and it's very hard to imagine them losing it now. Well, big news, a penalty has been awarded in one of the other games. Alan McInally.
It's a penalty for Manchester City. A slight delay as the ref clears the defenders. Up he steps. Oh, he's blasted it miles over. What?
Keeper getting the touch. Well, threat averted. Godus. And he read it well. Useful looking ball. Now the task is to remain focused. And the goalkeeper covered a lot of ground to push that away from danger. So 3 minutes of stoppage time coming up. And just the 1 minute left in normal time here. Careless in possession. Good vision. Can he get onto this? Oh, tremendous goal! Technical excellence to finish that one off. Wonderful to have that in your repertoire.
Well, here we can see, Derek, from this better angle, it's all about the technique. When you're volleying a ball, it's all about timing. Let it get to the right place for your foot to make the connection, and there you go, in the back of the net. Well, enjoy the good days as a coach. It can be a roller coaster ride, I can tell you that.
And so the final whistle, and this confirms it. They've come up short in their quest to win the title. A day to forget for the players, the fans, and everyone involved with the club league.
Yeah, you can see how distraught they are. They had visions of grandeur today. The fans are very disappointed as well. What I would say, though, they are building a very, very good team here. And I think they'll improve again in the transfer window. You have to fancy their chances next season.
Oh.